Good morning, it's time. It's the Jeffrey Lampkin Show. Listen, coming up on today's show, I'm doing a special dedication as we end Women's History Month. So of course, I've already had my older successful women on here, but today I'm bringing a young lady, a woman in training, to close out Women's History Month. Of course, Women's History Month was the month of March, and we had a lot of great women to come through and share so many talents and gifts that they've had. And now we're going to close it out with a young woman who is achieving. She is Miss Teen Black South Carolina 2015-2016, Ms. Amari Jones, and she's in the studio. So we're going to talk to her about life after holding the Covenant Crown, and also we're going to talk to her about what she's accomplishing and this new business that she has going on. It's happening this morning on the Jeffrey Lampkin Show. Your coffee cups are up, your pinkies are out, you're getting lamped. Good morning.
Here we go.
Everybody get up. Everybody get up. Come on. Just for you. Smiling out, cause God loves you. Somebody turn the lamp on.
Cannon and Graves is a proud sponsor of the Jeffrey Lampkin Show. Located at 1837 Wilson Road in Newberry, Cannon and Graves has the perfect certified used car for you. Their extensive inventory has something in every price range, and they can get everyone financed, regardless of credit. All cars come with a warranty to give you the peace of mind you deserve. Come see Steve and Reggie, and find your new car at Cannon and Graves.
Good morning. Welcome back to the Jeffrey Lampkin Show. Listen, put your coffee cups down right now. Of course, we're ending Women's History Month and the celebration of Women's History Month. And I am excited because, of course, I've been featuring older women, successful women who have already paved the way and made it happen for some of our younger girls. And I'm excited because I have a young lady, an up-and-coming woman who is going to be great, who's going to be successful, and she's already achieving milestones. And I'm excited that she is here on this morning. She won the Covenant title of Miss Teen Black South Carolina 2015-2016, and she is here on this morning. Everyone say good morning to Lady Amari Jones. Good morning, my love.
Good morning.
How are you this morning?
I'm doing good.
Wonderful. Y'all, she's nervous, but I'm gonna get it right. Don't worry. We're gonna loosen this thing up before it's all said and done. How are you feeling?
I'm feeling good.
You are absolutely beautiful. You are gorgeous. Like, if it was just based on looks alone, then I see why the judges chose you as Miss Teen Black South Carolina. How does it feel to carry that Covenant title this year?
I feel like I'm able to do so much with the title.
Okay.
Like, I can help younger girls, and then I get to experience new things, like go to different kind of camps and do stuff like that.
What has been the best thing so far? So far of winning the title, what has been like the best thing about being Miss Teen Black South Carolina?
The best thing so far is like expanding my horizon.
Okay.
So last summer, I went to a back-to-school bash, and then I had little Starbursts in a bowl.
Uh-huh.
And then I had little girls come pick the Starbursts out the bowl, and they were able to tell me what made them beautiful and everything like that.
Let me ask you a question. How did you, because to hear someone, because you're 15?
Yes, sir.
15 years old. So to hear someone who's 15 years old, you know, beginning to pour into other girls and say, you're beautiful, you're successful, you're smart, and all of these other things, when really it's at an age where we feel like someone should be pouring into you.
Mm-hmm.
What gives you the motivation and the self-esteem to be like, you know what, I know I'm beautiful, so let me pour into someone else?
My mama reminds me all the time.
Wow.
That I'm beautiful.
Come on, mama. Listen, you want to know why? You know, you ever heard a song, you get it from your mama?
Yes.
That's what it is. Uh-huh. See, mama knows she beautiful, so she's like, shout out to mama this morning. Mom's in the studio, and dad, and the brother. Everybody's here this morning. But it's a beautiful thing to know, and you're absolutely beautiful.
Thank you.
I love the fact that you embrace your natural.
Mm-hmm.
And you're like, you know, a lot of times when you see beauty queens, and this is nothing against those that do, you see them and they wear all the makeup,
mm-hmm,
and everything of that nature, but I need you all to, like, camera, get a good look this morning at her naturally beautiful, no enhancements, no makeup, none of that other stuff, great skin. And then you have a beauty mark right there. That's natural beauty, because natural beauty comes with the beauty mark. Come through right there. So talk to me real quick. So when you're, have you ever encountered before a young lady who, when you've told them that you're beautiful, you're sharing this with them, mm-hmm. has there ever been one that says, no, I'm not, or one that hasn't believed that in themselves that they are who you're telling them that they are?
Being that who I am, and then I surround myself with a lot of people who mm-hmm. have a higher self-esteem, mm-hmm. some of my friends, they might think that they're not beautiful, but they always, like, I'm able to help them, to encourage them, so they can know that they're beautiful and just wow. the skin that they're in.
Is it scary sometimes? Like, I guess because you're in high school. Mm-hmm. So, you know, in high school, like, we're in a different generation now. And in this time of day, you know, y'all wear, you know, makeup mm-hmm. and all sorts of things. Is there ever the temptation of, like, I want to do what other young girls do? In other words, what makes you be the trendsetter instead of following the crowd?
Because I always want to be different. I always wanted to, like, set the example for other people and then show them that it's okay to be different and it's okay to be yourself.
You ever had a moment where you just want to be like, whose child is this? Oh my God, yes! You are so amazing. So you go to Fairfield Central High School.
Yes, sir.
And you're in the
10th grade.
10th grade at Fairfield yes, Central High School. What is life like for you at school? Because, of course, and again, the show this morning, for everyone, all of my viewing audience, you know, I want you all, for my older people, I want you to see that there are some great young people out there who are achieving amazing things. And what she's giving you is not an act. When I met her this morning to bring her up to the studio, she was like, yes, sir. No, sir. It was very respectful. She's very mannerable. And a lot of times what we portray in media is, oh, you know, the young people out there just doing whatever it is they want. But let's remember the Bible. The Bible says train up a child in the way that he or she should go. And once he gets old, he won't depart. So what we're seeing is our future Michelle Obama. Y'all love Michelle Obama? Do you like Michelle Obama?
Yes.
Yes! Come to Michelle. She loves you, Michelle. Yes, she does. So, you know, but you're training, you're coming out and you're being that lady. So back to Fairfield Central High School. So you're at school, and there's a lot of peer pressure and different things like that. Do you deal with peer pressure?
Peer pressure is not really, like, a big factor in my life. Okay. I'm able to determine everything that I want to do, like, control myself around mm-hmm. different surroundings. Mm-hmm. Well, it is, like, for different people, mm-hmm. you can be pressured in school, but I'm not really pressured.
I love your mind just blows me, and that's just being totally honest, because to hear you talk from your perspective of what you deal with, but then you turn around and you can talk about your peers and what they mm-hmm. deal with. Do you lead a lot of groups and stuff at Fairfield Central? What do you do? What's some of your activities?
At school, I'm a part of the Beta Club.
Okay.
And then as a younger girl in elementary school.
Hey, hold on, because some of my viewers, real quick, I got a lot of older viewers out there, and I want to make sure they understand. Beta Club requires that you have a certain GPA
yes.
in order, and I believe it, you have to have a minimum B GPA, 3.0
yes,
GPA in order to be that. And then you have to have character initiatives that go along with it. So you have to have great character, you have to have moral standing and different mm-hmm. things like that. So that's a major accomplishment that you have. So you're part of the Beta Club, and what else?
The Beta Club, and then in elementary school, I was over it was this group called Legacy, Leading uh-huh. and Educating Girls Across South Carolina.
Okay.
So then I was able to lead each group. I had to tell them, like, the rules, the regulations, what was going to happen in that class and everything like that.
You're an example of leadership. And what I'm noticing is the pattern that you continue to grow and you continue to get bigger and you continue to do, and God continues to give you more things because you're obedient.
Mm-hmm.
Keep being obedient in what you're doing. So you're doing your thing at Fairfield Central High School. Now, let me ask this, because we all want to know. So what are you like at home? Because you have a little brother, right?
Yes.
Does he get on your nerves?
Sometimes.
Come through, Les. He gets on your nerves. We know it. That's what all little brothers. I was a little brother. I had a big sister. We're supposed to get on your nerves.
Well.
That's what we do. But we love. Do you cook for him?
Yes, sir. Because
somebody told me that you're a great cook.
Yes, sir.
We're going to find that out in the second half. But somebody told me that you're a great cook, so you love to cook. How did you
yes,
get into
sir.
Cooking?
I started cooking as an outlet just to express myself, and then I would look and I would see different things and see how, like, cupcakes, I saw watermelon mm-hmm, cupcakes, but mm-hmm. it's not really watermelon, it's just red. And it's so creative when you cook. You can, like, experience different things when you cook, so that's what I like.
So let me ask this question. Your grandma, where is she? Is she alive?
Yes, sir.
She's alive, and so she's around.
Yes, sir.
So there's like, do you hang with grandma or something? Does she teach you how to cook? Like, I'm trying to figure this thing out because you are just like the. My wife probably is watching right now, and I know that she is just like, yes, like, oh my God, I love her because you're so just. Mm-hmm. Oh, cool. Let's just give your mother a hand. Let's clap for your mama. Your mama did it. You know, daddy did it too because he kept her right. But your mama, Leela, is dead. We got to give it up for mama because mothers had to have that type mm-hmm. of influence. So you love to cook. You love to be out there and to doing things of mm-hmm. that nature. What's your future goals? What do you see yourself? Because you led a group in elementary school. You were leader. You were in leadership then. Mm-hmm. Of course, you came. You won Miss Teen Black South Carolina. Let me ask about Miss Teen Black South Carolina. Was that a scary experience?
Seeing the eyes look at you and everything, it was scary, okay. but then you're able to overcome it once you get finished, like once you get out there in the crowd uh-huh. and you see them looking, it's kind of like them saying you can do it. When they look at you and then you see it and then it's like amazing when you feel like you accomplished everything.
I know we got to go to commercial break, but tell me a little bit about the pageant. Like, what were some of the things that you had to do in order to capture the crown of Miss Teen South Carolina Black?
To capture the crown, when we first had to walk out, I was one of the first contestants. I was okay. contestant number one, so I was the first one out there.
Oh, you were the trendsetter yes. again. Y'all, look at this. It is a cycle, honey. She was the trendsetter, okay? Huh? So you were number one.
Yes,
you
sir.
Came out, and everybody had to come behind you, and they just didn't bring what you brought. You mm-hmm. were snatched, laid to the gods, and ready to go, huh? Come through. Come through. Yes, number one. So you had to, you came out. You were, you had outfits and everything. Was there a talent portion or anything? Interviews,
we had to
questions?
Do, we did have an interview. It was a 5-minute song, and okay. then they asked me things about how I like to cook okay. and what made me different from the other contestants.
Okay.
And then after that, we had to do a dance portion. And then after that, they asked us an onstage question.
You can dance?
We had to learn to dance.
Because you know I don't have no rhythm. They tell me that I don't have rhythm at all. Now, I think that I can move, you know, but they tell me, no, don't do that. And when I'm directing a choir, my choir tells me, please do not at all whatsoever. Listen, we got to go. When we come back, I heard that there's some cupcakes. I am hungry. Yes, I know it is early in the morning, but I'm going to eat these cupcakes. So we're going to do that for a little bit. And then we're also going to talk because I want to play a game with you. I want to mm-hmm. find out if Amari was in leadership, what would that be like? Listen, keep it right here. More is happening on The Jeffrey Lampkin Show. It's Sunday morning. And you should be getting dressed for church. Go ahead and slap that wig, shift it real quick. Come on, sit it to the side, get the comb out, ha ha. Slap some grease on it, get it together. It's gonna be a great morning. Your coffee cups are up, your pinkies are out, you're getting lamped. Good morning.
Kennan and Graves is a proud sponsor of the Jeffrey Lampkin Show. Located at 1837 Wilson Road in Newberry, Kennan and Graves has the perfect certified used car for you. Their extensive inventory has something in every price range, and they can get everyone financed, regardless of credit. All cars come with a warranty to give you the peace of mind you deserve. Come see Steve and Reggie, and find your new car at Kennan and Graves.
Good morning. We're back here on the Jeffrey Lampkin Show. Listen, put your coffee cups down right now. We are having a wonderful time with Miss Teen Black South Carolina 2015-2016, Miss Amari Jones. And I'm excited that Amari is here because one of the things that I wanted to do was really devote a show. Of course, we were celebrating Women's History Month. For those of you that are just joining us, we've been celebrating all month. We've had some amazing women to come through and actually showcase and tell who they are. But I wanted to take time for a show to dedicate to a young woman who's successful, who's achieving, who's accomplishing things, and it's going to be greatness in the future. And Amari, so first of all, you are on the Beta Club. You are Miss Teen Black South Carolina. Mm-hmm. You hold a 3.8 GPA. Okay, come through now. So when we talk about that and you see all of these great things that are, do you go to church?
Yes, sir.
I love it. Come through. What church do you go to?
We got to get Word Alive Worship Center.
Listen,
I've been there for like a year.
Come on now. And who's your pastor?
Andre Small.
Listen, we got to give the pastor a shout out. You know, pastor's like the, pastor, this is your member. Huh? This is your member. She's there. So I love it. Let's talk real quick. Okay. So we want to play a game because we want to get to know Amari. We want to mm-hmm. learn things about Amari. Then we're going to talk about these cupcakes because I can't hold out too much longer. She brought me some cupcakes. Y'all know I'm ready. But here we go. When we think about, do you watch television?
Yes, sir.
Empire or Scandal?
Neither one of those.
Love and Hip Hop?
Yeah.
I got to remember that I'm talking to my young people. I got to get my mind right. So you like Love and Hip, Real Housewives?
A little bit. I don't know a lot of it.
Okay, so what type of shows what type of shows does a 15-year-old watch?
Honestly, watch Love and Hip Hop. I like Martin. I like
Come on, throwback! Yes! Come on! on. Yes, we love Martin. Come on, Gina. Good morning, Gina. Yes. All right.
I like Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. Yes. I like watching Cupcake Wars, and I like watching Chopped.
Of course, because you cook, because you love to cook. Yes, and you got this thing for cooking, and your cooking ability came from you actually just one day, instead of getting out in the street. And the parents, this is why I tell you, training up a child. Instead of having your child hanging out in the street, going to this one house and that one house, they might say that they're bored at the house, but if they're bored at the house, it will give them the intuition to begin to do things. And so you started baking cupcakes.
Yes, sir.
Got into, of all things, cupcakes. Do you like sweets?
Like, after I cook, because I like to cook dinner, too, because as inspiration from watching Chopped, then I want to try cooking different foods and stuff like that. So then after I eat the savory foods, then I want something sweet.
Come on. So I'm telling y'all now, this child is about to be somebody politician. She didn't say eating good food. She said the savory food. Please, say it again. The what type of food? Say it again.
Savory.
Say the savory food. I'm going to use that today. She said, after eating the savory food. Okay, Amari. That gave me all. You were giving me my life. This morning. So you make cupcakes.
Yes, sir.
And let's take a look. Can we zoom in real quick on these cupcakes? I'm about to eat them. They're about to be demolished. Don't judge me. James Patrick, don't you come for me. I'm going to eat my cupcakes this morning. Are you able to get them in the camera? Are we able to see? Which camera am I going to? There we go. All right. Oh, here we go. Beautiful, beautiful. All right. So where was your inspiration when it came to baking cupcakes? You were just...
One day I was just sitting at home and I was looking on the internet, looking at different things, and then I was inspired. Then I want to make cupcakes and see if I can do.
These two type of cupcakes are what?
The one with the yellow icing is vanilla with buttercream. The icing is buttercream, and then the other one is strawberry with a lemon.
Okay, so when you do you ever like get the opportunity to like sell your cupcakes and different
things
like that?
For real? I went to I think it was called the Butterfly Festival in Blythewood. I went to there. So I could sell them, and then that way I could showcase my business and get it out more.
These are good.
Thank you.
Who taught you how to cook?
I told you.
You really did it yourself?
Yes.
Somebody taught her, honey. This is like an old mother's cooking, okay? Okay, so let me ask this question. Because you're now into, because this is what I want people to see. You are into entrepreneurship. You have your own business. You're only 15 years old. Mm-hmm. You won the covenant title of Miss Teen Black South Carolina. You have a 3.8 GPA, you're in high school, you're doing all of these things, and you're young. So a lot of people will say, oh, well, I'm supposed to be hanging out with my friends, going to the mall, doing all sorts of things like that. What makes you stay so focused on being successful?
I don't want to say that I don't like going to the mall or stuff like that. I do enjoy doing that, and I enjoy going out with my friends. But what makes me so different is because I'm able to balance the time between going with my friends and then being at home, like going to church, doing my schoolwork, and everything. I have good time management skills, so I'm able to do everything that I want to do.
What do you ultimately want to be?
I want to own my own daycare where I can teach children how to learn how to cook and respect themselves, and then that way, education and everything else.
And what I love about you is that you believe in ownership, and we need more people that believe in owning their own selves. It's not that you want to be a teacher and you want to go in a classroom, and nothing wrong with being a teacher, but what I love is that she's thinking big picture. And I'm going to tell you, Amari, you're going to accomplish it. Sometimes you can look at an individual and you're able to tell just by their mannerisms, their character, the way that they carry themselves. And anybody that says that the food is savory, that food is savory. Yeah, you're going to be something mighty and great in the kingdom of God and in this world. And you're going to be used. Like, stick with your purpose. Stay forward and what you're doing, keep moving, and I promise you, like, great things are going to happen.
Thank you.
They're going to come your way. Who's your favorite music artist?
My favorite music artist, I like Drake. I like listening to him.
Okay. I like Drake some days. It depends on the day. I do like Drake. Drake, I like you. I really do. Let me ask this question. K. Michelle or Beyonce?
I do watch K. Michelle, but I like Beyonce. I think she's more of a role model than K. Michelle.
Amari, you giving me my life this morning. You are so honored, but she is. Keep going.
Yeah, because K. Michelle is like, I don't know, like, how to explain what she...
But just, yeah. Beyonce
she might be too much. Yeah.
Just a little too much at mm-hmm. times. Just a little too much. Yeah. Just a little too much. You're a little extra, K. Michelle. What's your favorite food to eat? What's your favorite restaurant?
My favorite restaurant is Sumo's. I like the Japanese place. I like to eat there.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Is that the one off of, is it off of Clemson Road?
Yes, sir.
Off of Clemson Road, right? Yes. Mm-hmm. I love hibachi now. Yeah. Like, they start chop. You like that egg? Wow. Yes. I was like, come on here. So like Japanese, you like hibachi. What is your, and so you like music. Now, what's your favorite color?
My favorite color is lavender purple.
Okay. So when we think about women like Oprah Winfrey mm-hmm. and Michelle Obama, would you consider them inspirations for you?
Yes, sir. They are inspirational. Like Michelle Obama, she wants like the healthier children. Mm-hmm. She wants everybody to be healthy mm-hmm. and everybody to be able to live longer and take care of themselves. Mm-hmm. So she is an inspiration for everybody to do well.
And so as you continue your reign as Miss Teen Black South Carolina, what are some of your future goals and desires that you want to do as you continue your reign? Until you have to turn over the title to someone else, what are some things you would like to accomplish?
Until I finish my reign, I still want to do more, like expand my business more. Uh-huh. I want to get more information out about how you should love yourself, mm-hmm. positive body image, athletics. I want everything so everybody can know you need That's to take amazing. Care of yourself and you need to live long.
Well, you know, come on. Yeah. Ooh, Amara, you have given me all my life this morning, and I know that the viewers out there feel the exact same way. Thank you for being an example. Thank you for being a role model. And thank you. You know what? And I just feel like this is time. This is sometimes what we need to stop on television. I thank God for giving me the platform, because sometimes this is what we need to stop on television and display. We share so much negative energy, so much negative vibrations. But to sit here this morning and to see a 15-year-old young lady who's accomplishing things at the level that Amara is accomplishing and carrying the covenant title of Miss Black Teen South Carolina 2015-2016. She speaks so eloquently. She talks so well. You can see that God truly is inside of her. All of my professional women out there, I challenge you this morning, reach out to me. Find her. Are you on Facebook?
Yes, sir.
You are on Facebook. Amara Jones on
yes,
Facebook.
Sir.
Find her, because my thing is this. Someone needs to be mentoring her. Someone needs to be developing her. And you don't become successful to hold offices, to hold titles and things for yourself. But you need to take a young girl like this one who has potential beyond her wildest dreams, and you need to help her, craft her, mold her, show her, develop her. And it doesn't mean you're not there to raise her. You're there to develop her. See, mama's already raised her. That's why she's graceful and at the level that she is. But what we need is someone to come in and say, you know what, and I'm just challenging you this morning. They didn't ask me to do this. I'm saying this because, do you have a mentor right now?
Denise Clark, yes,
okay,
sir.
So she's one of your mentors.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so she has one mentor, and there are other, like, y'all, it takes a village to raise a child. So we need to come together, put our arms around these young Black women and these young Black men, and not just Black women, but period, all across the board. Young people, period. Black, white, Mexican, Latino, I don't care. Everyone needs to be mentored, developed, and cared for. Amari, I thank you so much. Any final words you want to share with the viewers before we go?
I would like to say that everyone should be true to themselves and to love themselves so you can live long.
Yes, listen, love the skin that you're in. Listen, I love it. You have just made my morning. I'm going to enjoy my cupcakes. It's going to be a great day. Keep it right here. I'm coming back with final words. Your coffee cups are up. Your pinkies are out. You're getting lamped. Good morning. Wow, what an amazing show. I absolutely love her. Amara Jones, 2015-2016, Miss Black Teen South Carolina. I really encourage all of you, some lady out there, I need you all to get on the mentorship band. Like, we need to wrap our arms around such a vessel that's going to be something major, a force to be reckoned with. And I want to definitely make sure that she's getting developed. So reach out to me, Facebook or Instagram or email, thejeffreylampkinshow@gmail.com. And of course, we can make that connection happen for you. And of course, follow Amara as well, as she is on Facebook. I wanted to share, as we close out Women's History Month, I love women. Anyone who knows me knows that I love women. I celebrate women. I tell you, if I was the president of the United States of America, I probably would push the platform of making sure that there are equal rights for women. And I know that many of you may say, why, Jeffrey, women have come so far. Yes, they have. I mean, look at Senator and former Secretary of State Hillary Rodham Clinton. Of course, she is about to be the next president. Yes, I'm going to go ahead and put that stamp right there. there and put it into the atmosphere, into the air. But women are accomplishing so many things. You're entrepreneurs. You're making it happen. You're mothers, your wives, your sisters, your friends. You are beautiful. You are vivacious. You are absolutely wonderful. And one thing about it is that we, the male creature, can't get enough of you. Don't stop till you get enough. So we celebrate you in the month of March. But my thing is, we're not just gonna celebrate you in the month of March, we're gonna celebrate you year round. And here's what I want you, my viewers, to realize and to understand, that while we have made great strides in showing our women and displaying them and giving them opportunities, there needs to be even more. The pay scale is not even equal. The opportunities that are afforded to men as versus afforded to women are not equal. There are some changes that need to be made. And while we have to highlight what our women are doing, if we really be serious about it, women make the world go round. That is the true nature of it. You're beautiful, you're wonderful with your emotional selves. Yes, you are emotional, but guess what? That's who you are. Embrace the inner you and love the inner you. You are the only creatures that are able to do things to yourself. What are you talking about, Jeffrey? You can put on a wig today, put on lashes tomorrow, put on a mixed makeup, change to this color, to that color. You can do all sorts of things. But at the end of the day, when we unmask all of that, you are who you are. You are beautiful. And so we celebrate you. And I wanted to take one moment, one show, to take the time to say that, you know what, you're making great contributions to the world. And I know that some people are gonna sit here and feel like this was a waste of a month, this was a waste of time or a waste of a show. I don't care, because my thing is that God has given me a platform to change, to be the trendsetter. I'm not gonna do what's popular, I'm going to do what's right. And so doing what's right means that I'm going to celebrate everyone. I'm going to celebrate people. And so we're celebrating women in the month of March, and I can begin to call off so many names. First Lady Michelle Obama, Hillary Rodham Clinton, Yolanda Adams, and I'm just gonna call women who I think are inspirational. Sadie Lampkin, Attorney Harriet, Hugh Lampkin, Michelle Lampkin, Janet Parker, Darcy Strickland, Judy Gatson, the names go on and on, of women that I just admire and I adore. Star Jones, Sherry Shepherd, Barbara Walters. I can go on and on, because women are just absolutely amazing. We love you, and there's nothing that anyone can do about it. Erica Campbell, Tina Campbell, I can go on and on. You are wonderful. Tamika Isaac Devine, you are gorgeous. Carolyn Brelsford, you are beautiful. Cynthia Hardy, you are amazing. Melissa Evans Pauling, Kimberly Suber, you are what excellence looks like. You are what extraordinary looks like. Deborah Lee, Wendy Williams. We can go on and on, local, national, whoever it may be, we can do it. However, at the end of the day, I got to go. There's so much that needs to be done. But ladies, I celebrate you in the month of March. The Jeffrey Lampkin Show salutes you. Keep doing what you're doing. It's been an amazing day. We'll be back next month. More great things are happening. Your coffee cups are up, your pinkies are out, and you've been lamped.
Good morning.
Everybody get up. Come on.
Just for you. Smile and laugh, 'cause God loves you.
Lamp.
Somebody turn the lamp on.